Who has heard the word pernil and not have your mouth water? But today, we're doing something different. We are doing pernil guisado with arroz con gandules. Let's make it, shall we? Welcome to my workshop. So the story goes that the word pernil comes from the Catalan language and it means ham. A true pernil comes from the ham, which is the back leg of the pork. With that being said, any fatty part of the pork makes a great pernil. It could be the shoulder, the picnic, but originally it's the ham, which is the back leg of the pork. Let's make mine. All right, so I wash and dry the pernil steaks. I cut them into 2-inch pieces, and I will season with my homemade adobo. In a large pot, I'm gonna add the oil and put the pork. And I'm not touching it. I'm just gonna let it brown. I'm not gonna bother it. The pork has done nothing to me, so I'm just gonna let it brown and not touching it. I'm not gonna play with it. That's one of the most important parts of cooking. Sometimes people get a little excited and they get a little crazy by touching, moving, going nuts on it. Let the meat cook, let it brown, let those sugars come out, and let those flavors build. And most of it, I just want to create the fond, or fondo, which is the bottom of the pot, all those brown bits. That's the best part, and there's a lot of flavor there. The only way that we can develop that is by letting it be. After about 5 minutes, I'm going to move the pork, I'm going to stir it, and put the other parts in the bottom so they can get brown too. Now, I will remove the pork once it's brown to the color that I want, and I'm gonna strain it. I'm gonna reserve the fat in there, and then I'm gonna add 2 tablespoons of the pork fat back into the pot, and I'm gonna mix it with a little bit of olive oil, and I'm gonna add all the aromatics, the onions, the peppers, the garlic, and I'm just gonna build the flavor there and wait until they're kind of translucent. Add the sofrito, fry it. Then add the tomato paste. The wine and the spices. And now you can see that the bottom of the pan or the pot is clean. All those beautiful flavors that were stuck on the bottom, they are now on the sauce. So now I'm gonna add the pork and the water, bring it to a boil, simmer for about 25 minutes, and then I'm gonna add the potatoes. Simmer for another 20-25 minutes until the potatoes are cooked and the guiso or the stew has thickened enough that I like it that way. Now, while this pork is cooking and it's going, let's start with arroz con gandules. Put the rest of the fat from the pork in a caldero, then add the olive oil. I'm gonna add the aromatics, the sofrito, tomato sauce, the gandules, all the seasonings, and the water. Today I'm using 4 cups of washed rice. I wash it first. 5 cups of water, just because I have enough water in the gandules and I have enough water liquids with the tomato sauce and so forth. Now that the water is boiling, I'm gonna add the rice, I'm gonna stir. Let it come to a boil, don't touch it anymore. Reduce it to a medium heat and wait for the water to evaporate without disturbing it. Do not touch it, let it be. Once the water has evaporated, I will stir the whole caldero, making sure that I grab everything and stir it, every side, every part. Reduce the heat to a low cover it, and cook it for an additional 20 to 30 minutes until it is to my liking. If you want to make some pegao, all you have to do is once it's over, you can put it back up to about a medium heat and just listen to it. Once you hear the rice sizzling, that means the pegao is forming, but you have to watch it if you're going to put it back into a medium heat. Now, look at that. This is mouth-watering. Pernil guisado con arroz con gandules. You definitely need to try this pernil this way. You will not believe how much flavor is in that pork, how beautiful that sauce develops. Garnish with some peas, red peppers, and serve it family style and watch it disappear. You definitely can serve it with some avocado salad, tostones de pana, tostones plantain, whatever you want. You can serve it with a little yuca al mojo or even amarillos or sweet plantains. I hope you enjoyed this recipe because está exquisito este plato. Remember, the recipe is under the video's bio on my YouTube channel, Chef Tito's Workshop. Remember to follow me TikTok, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and here on Facebook. I will see you next time. God bless. Ciao.